The distant smells of fresh whole bug bread led them home. The bard swore to write a heroic song of the pair's quest. Reggie wondered what would rhyme with zombie. Reggie didn't tell his brother of the undead yet. They still had living enemies to fight, weapons to forge, and a book full of blueprints thought to be lost. Stories could wait. Though the kitchen and smithy were restored and improved, Reggie looked at his broken, gore-smeared throne room. No self-respecting king could rule from here. The costs, as usual, never went down. White paint from iridescent larva shells. A perfect finishing touch to any wooden construction. Rat was willing to part ways with his compass for the right price. This fine compass was ideal for a ranger tracking beasts in the wild. The farmer's bees had been lost in the invasion. He would buy a new hive, if only he had the materials. The woodcutter had a wheel. He was willing to part with it for a price. Mozzie King. Smaller than his female counterpart, but just as ferocious. The ranger wanted to find fresh hunting grounds, but without a compass, he couldn't map them. The compass had guided the ranger to new hunting grounds. He gave his first kill to the king in gratitude. The chef's cellar would soon be overflowing. Buzzing, then the stench of rotten meat. The Mozzie King had come for him. He wasn't the only king with a sting in his tail. Yeah. king dead, hopefully the waves of Mozzie infestations would slow down. Her offspring were all dead, and the mother had come to get her revenge. Thank you. the Mozzie Queen, foul mother of the swarm. Never stop what she is. The Mozzie Queen, foul mother of the storm. They set to stop while she lives. The mother dead? That should be the last of them. For now. was this strange creature? Everything about it unsettled him. He must be cautious.